Glitter Box. I've got something here that you don't ever want to turn down. Something for your mind, your body, and your soul.
Such an instantly recognisable track right here. I love this. Gwen Guthrie and Seventh Heaven. Before we get into that one, I'll say hello, welcome along. You're listening to the Glitterbox Radio Show, as always with me, Melvo Baptiste. Yes, it's a brand new week, and yes, we have loads more amazing music to play you. However, today, we do it with a little bit of a difference. If you guys remember a few months back on this show, we done a tribute to Frankie Knuckles, a really popular show. Just last week, the 20th of July, would have marked the birthday of the one and only Larry Levan. We felt it only right to pull some music together today, a few of the tracks that he was famous for playing at the Garage in New York, and also some records that he heavily influenced and remixed over the years. Also today we'll be speaking to some people who were heavily impacted by his legacy and his career. We'll be hearing from Arthur Baker, Norman Jay, Jocelyn Brown and Louis Vega as well. As always, you guys want to get in touch, you can find us on Twitter at Glitterbox, or you can find us on Facebook and Instagram at Glitterbox Ibiza. But as mentioned, we'll kick off right here. Gwen Guthrie, Seventh Heaven, and this, our tribute to Larry Levan. Welcome along.
Yeah. We'll be right back. Hi, this is Arthur Baker, producer and DJ. I have to say Larry LeBand was one of the best DJs I ever heard, and one of the most creative and one of the most fearless. Larry would love a track and would play it to death, and if people didn't get it, he'd play it again. I mean, he would just play a track five times in a night and wouldn't care if it cleared the dance floor the first three times. But by the end of the night, you know, everyone would be going nuts over the track because he just had a great taste. That's probably one of his strong qualities, was his taste. One of the proudest moments I had was hearing him play a track of mine for the first time at Paradise Garage. It would have been the TJM album, which Tom Moulton put out, and I had two tracks that he played off of that, one being Put Yourself in My Place and the other being I Don't Need No Music. And hearing those tracks at Paradise Garage just blew my mind. And, you know, it was like an addiction. You had to have your tracks played at the Paradise Garage. As far as influencing me as a producer, his work with the New York City Peach Boys, his dub work with them was very influential in my early dance music production career, being the way he worked the hand claps and the dubs. And the dub of Don't Make Me Wait was one of those tracks you never forget hearing for the first time. He, along with Francois, who also was influential at that point with that dub technique, influenced me. And obviously, when I did Walking on Sunshine by Rocker's Revenge, I took bits of that. And basically, you know, both of those DJ producers influenced me on that. He also had a great sense of humor, Larry, which people don't talk, well, maybe people do talk about, but he would, you know, I'd go to the garage and bring him a track, and, you know, usually he would eventually play my tracks. If there was one point where he'd play all my tracks, but he would make you wait and wait. And basically, when I brought him Walking on Sunshine the first time, I waited till like 5:30, 6 in the morning, and I left. And then the next morning, my friend Bobby Shaw, who is a club promoter, he called me up and said, "Hey man, did you hear Larry played your track?" I go, "When did he play it?" He said, "Oh yeah, about 10 minutes after he saw that you left." So that was Larry LeBand's sense of humor. His talent has been untouched. He was one of the most fearless DJs that I've ever known and seen, and he's so missed by everybody. Don't make me wait. Enough to experience Lauryn Hill in the flesh at the Paradise Garage when I went there for the first time in the summer of 1985. I had a high level of expectation because I'd been buying his remixes and post-productions for a number of years. I was a big fan even before I got there, and I kind of went there expecting to hear a lot of his older stuff that he'd mixed and played, but actually he was playing the new sound at the time, which was the new Chicago house and the new New York dance, as it was called. I mean, we both know those genres as those sounds as house music, but it was championing the sounds mainly from New York and quite a lot of early Chicago stuff as well. And so it was a really sort of brilliant experience. So I went there about perhaps a dozen times before it closed in September 1987. He was incredible because, you know, a lot of the music, I'd say about 70, maybe 80% of the music he was playing, I knew, I was aware of, but not, I hadn't heard the versions he was playing. I hadn't heard it mixed the way he was mixing it, and I hadn't heard it played the way he was playing it. It was absolutely, you know, inspiring for me, you know, on my early trips there.
Wicked.
And I was fortunate enough to see some PAs there as well during Lowe's night on the Saturday nights. Amazing.
are listening to Melvo Baptiste on the Glitterbox Radio Show.
Thank you. Special to all of us. Larry Levan is the man, and he was really the maestro of maestros, one of them. I mean, you know, when I think of the true pioneers, you think of Francis Grasso, you think of David Mancuso, Nicky Ciano, Larry Levan, Tony Humphries. You know, he was on it. A lot of the music that he chose and played ended up being a lot of, you know, the soundtracks to a lot of our lives. I mean, New York City was on fire with music because all the DJs followed what Larry did, you know. We went out there, listened to what he was playing, and we went out and bought those records. You know, so imagine you had incredible dancers and DJs, music aficionados, just people who loved good music going out to this amazing place in New York City. I mean, it was like going to church every week, you know. So I was lucky to go when I was young, thanks to my sisters and my neighbor who were members. But man, you know, I went in 1980 and I went all the way until 87. You know, and that's when the garage closed. But I spent a lot of really good times there and learned so much about music just by listening to the great Larry Levan. Want to wish Larry Levan a very happy birthday. So just want to say thank you to Larry Levan for being such a great inspiration in my life and made me want to work hard to be who I am today.
Radio Show.
Give you.
go back, way back, back into time. These are the sounds of Glitterbox.
In my life, did a song called Ain't No Mountain High Enough. And when she made a, not just a 12 inch, but he made into a, almost a half an hour to an hour album, excuse me, single. And they used it in the clubs. It became a national club anthem for the garage in New York City. I was quite impressed and I was quite overwhelmed because I never knew that he would involve himself so much in a recording that I did, and he did. From that recording, he became a very fixture position in my life. He'd come to my house, and we fried chicken, and act up, you know, and talk, and go over everything, and he'd tell me what he's getting ready to do, you know. He knew that things were going kind of strangely with him physically and health-wise, but we didn't talk about that. What we talked about was the kind of music to do, and, you know, who was good at doing what they were doing, and how it sounded, and let's listen to some other stuff that's just come out, especially Europe stuff and European music. And he was a candidate to try it out, him and Frankie, not Frankie Knuckles, but Frankie was involved in that as well. But him and a lot of other DJs from the radio stations were all involved with it. And he had a very great position with a lot of them. Not to mention the fact that he was wonderful. He was a wonderful guy. He was sweet. He was silly. He acted up. We laughed hard about things. But more than anything else, his heart was in the right place. He was a good guy. And he did the best that he could do without getting jammed up. You know, other people taking his product from him or snatching his opportunity to work and become more well-known. But the garage was a fixated place for him. He became a national star there. And everybody came to hear him play, you know. So my life with him was saying, no mountain high enough. Started my career on another level, which was the house music level. It was him, Larry and me, you know, and all others that followed behind it. I'm grateful to him.
Ooh, I ain't going nowhere.
Finishing up today, quite simply, on one of my favourite records of all time. I love this mix. And if you guys remember back to when we had Valerie Simpson on the show, told us the full story about how this record came to be. Inner Life, featuring Jocelyn Brown and Ain't No Mountain High Enough. And there you have it, our tribute to Larry Levan. I hope you guys enjoyed the show today. Sending a big shout, as mentioned, to Arthur Baker, to Norman Jay, to Jocelyn Brown, and also to Louis Vega as well. I have to mention just before we go, this coming Saturday is, of course, our return to Ministry of Sound. There is still a few remaining tickets for that. If you do want to get involved, head over to glitterboxibiza.com and pick up some tickets right now. The lineup is amazing. It's going to be an incredible day, especially with the heatwave we currently have in London. So as mentioned, we'll leave you guys with this one today, and we look forward to seeing you on Saturday at Ministry.